move notice of motion, private business number 379.
I move that I agree to the bill for an act to amend the gentle modified crops management act.
Please
grab
it, please grab it.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, I'm reintroducing this bill today as a measure to protect South Australian farmers from being placed in the invidious position of having to sue their neighbours if they are in the unfortunate position of suffering economic loss as a result of having their land contaminated against their will by genetically modified crops that escape from other farms. This is exactly the circumstance that arose a couple of years ago in Western Australia, where a farmer, Seaman Marsh, lost his organic certification over 70% of his farm following contamination by wind-blown genetically modified canola from a neighbouring property. That court case was decided last week, and Mr. Marsh lost. The case was decided in favour of his GM canola farming neighbour. It's important to understand, however, that this case wasn't about whether growing GM crops is a good idea, but it was confined very closely to its particular facts. The judge, Justice Kenneth Martin of the West Australian Supreme Court, ultimately agreed that yes, GM material had escaped and entered Mr. Marsh's land, and yes, he had lost his organic certification as a result, and yes, losing his organic certification had cost him money, from memory, around $80,000. But what the court wasn't prepared to do was to say that it was his neighbour's fault. Ultimately, the court sheeted home the blame for Mr. Marsh's loss to NASA, the National Association of Sustainable Agriculture, which is the certifying authority. The court effectively accused NASA of being too fussy about its requirements for what is an organic farm, and His Honour said that it had behaved unreasonably in withdrawing Mr. Marsh's organic accreditation as a result of what the court believed was a fairly minor contamination. It was, in effect, a case of shooting the messenger. I think that decision is a very disappointing one, but we would be fooling ourselves if we think that this is the final word in the inevitable conflict that will arise between GM farmers and organic farmers, or even traditional non-GM farmers. As other states succumb to the power of the multinationals and they allow GM crops, other farmers, such as here in South Australia, where a moratorium prevails, will still face a very high chance of contamination, particularly from across the border in Victoria, as well as escapes from so-called trial crops already being grown in the southeast. But getting back to Mr. Marsh in Western Australia, his situation was very different to those that South Australian farmers find themselves in, because for starters, he wasn't a canola grower. So according to the court, he should not have been affected by the escaping GM material from his canola growing neighbour. Mr. Marsh grew wheat and rye, and he raised sheep. In the southeast of our state, however, you do find farmers growing canola right up to the Victorian border. And over the border, GM crops are allowed, and there will not be a buffer of any substance. The Greens strongly support the continuation of the moratorium on GM crops in South Australia, but contamination from over the border is a certainty, and escape from so-called trial crops in South Australia is also likely. So when escapes happen, and if economic loss occurs, then what is to be done? We know what we don't want, and that's what happened in Western Australia. It's a terrible situation to find farmer suing the farm. That's why South Australian farmers need legal protection and a clearer pathway to redress if they do suffer economic loss. This bill tries to avoid the situation that Mr. Marsh faced, where his only avenue for justice Genetically Modified Crops Management Right to Damages Amendment Bill will enable a person who suffers damages as a result of genetically modified plant material contaminating their land to sue companies who own and sell the technology. And that includes multinational companies such as Monsanto and Bayer Crop Science. In short, the buck should stop with these big multinationals that profit most from GM crops. Our farmers have a right to some level of security and protection, and I believe they do have a right to compensation if they are invaded by GM crops escaping from elsewhere. This bill places the responsibility on these big multinational companies that push the technology to make sure that they are responsible for ensuring there is no contamination of neighbouring farms. And it does this by hitting them hard in the pocket when things go wrong. So this bill effectively creates a right of action in the name of a South Australian farmer against the technology owner of these GM crops. I don't need to go through all of the details of the bill because, as I've said, I'm reintroducing this bill. For those members who want more information and those reading the Hansard, I refer them to the debate on the 2nd of May 2012, and I commend the bill to the House.
Mr. Stevens.
Move debate adjourned.
Seconded, Stevens.